Incredible. Amazing.
Come on.
I came here with your weather. Well, it looks like it's going to be hot out all weekends with some thunderstorms. So train the bathing suits for an umbrella. Friday, June 11th, it's going to be a high of 83 and a low of 67 with 60% humidity with scare thunderstorms. It looks like it's going to be a hot record high day with the record set at 91 degrees in 1976. Saturday, June 12th, it's going to be a high of 86 with a low of 67 with 60% humidity and scattered thunderstorms. The UV index is really high this weekend, so get out the sunscreen and lather up. You don't want to get burnt. Sunday, June 13th, it's a high of 82 and a low of 62 with 10% humidity and partly cloudy. It's looking hotter than average today with an average of 77 degrees. And here now to Alex with the world news.
Now it's me, Alex, with the world news. In headlines this week, the FIFA World Cup is starting June 11th. This event is taking place in South Africa and goes until July 11th. The teams competing include the USA, Argentina, Mexico, England, Brazil, Australia, Chile, and many more. Most of the players, though, are complaining about the World Cup ball used for the games. The ball is made by Adidas, and they make the ball for every World Cup. The ball is dreadful, says England goalkeeper David James. Most players are unhappy with the ball and how bouncy it is. Some players say the ball is geared towards only certain types of players. In other headlines across the world, gas prices have surprisingly dropped. Predictions were that by Memorial Day, the gas prices should have risen to about $3 a gallon. Contrast to the prediction, prices have been well below $3. This lowering in prices has said to have been caused by rising concern of our economy, helping wholesale gas prices lower. In July 2008, gas prices peaked at $4.11. This July's average gas prices aim to be around $2.70, which is a substantial decrease. Also in headlines, it is over the 50th day of the oil catastrophe. The oil is now reaching Florida and reaching most Gulf Coast beaches. Florida's tourism has doubled since 2005, and now they are worried that tourism will substantially drop because of the tar balls on the beaches and oil in the water. BP is now saying the oil catastrophe could last well into the fall, and the four states affected by this nasty oil spill, Louisiana being the worst, they have over 150 miles of affected coast. Most wetlands are pretty much destroyed now due to the oil. And now on to Alex with movie reviews.
Last weekend, I went out to theaters to see the new comedy called MacGruber, a spy comedy that mainly parodies the 80s television show MacGyver, which follows a secret agent who is known for being very resourceful and making weapons and gadgets out of ordinary items. As it turns out, MacGruber is also the name of a Saturday Night Live sketch and which the movie is based on. The story follows a veteran super spy named MacGruber, obviously, who goes after his arch-nemery, Dieter von Kampf, who has stolen a nuclear warhead. Accompanying MacGruber is Lieutenant Dixon Piper, a rookie Green Beret, and Vicky Elmo, MacGruber's longtime friend. The humor in the movie is very dirty, obviously, and at times makes the scary movie feels seem mature compared to MacGruber's disgusting form of comedy. I found myself wincing instead of laughing at certain scenes of the movie that earned DRA. I think you know what I'm talking about here. Despite this, I still found myself laughing through the whole movie because of the great script and over-the-top character of MacGruber. I would recommend this to anyone who likes movies like Step Brothers and The Hangover, but to anyone who wants a tasteful comedy, steer clear of MacGruber.
Oh, well, looks like it's going to be... Oh my God, I can't even read. Oh, I'm Danny. Oh my God, restart.